What's up, guys? It's me, Mikey Pipes, with Stoli, the mini golden doodle, and Gigi, the mini golden doodle. In this video, I'm gonna do something I haven't done in a while, and that is walk into a house where the homeowner has COVID. Yep, they got a case of Corona. And not the Corona you drink, not that one. So apparently, the homeowner is fed up with their service provider, and she mentions it by name, or the company by name, and I don't like to speak bad about other contractors. It's not the professional thing to do, but I'm gonna listen to what they have to say, like I did in this video during this service call. And we're going to gather information, listening and paying close attention to the information that we gather. All right, that's a good rule of thumb as an observant technician. You need to ask questions, listening to what the client tells you, and decipher that so you could make a good diagnosis. Most of the times it's helpful and sometimes it's not, but pay close attention to the questions that I ask, and hopefully we can all learn from one another. And at the end, I'm gonna follow up and ask you, what would you do?
I know, you got the...
I got it.
You got the China virus.
Yeah.
So before I come in...
Wait, first of all, I can give you...
I have a mask.
You have, okay.
I have, but before I come in, let's just have a conversation.
Okay.
You wanna just, we can talk outside.
Okay.
Tell me what happened.
And I have OSI for oil,
yes,
and whatever. I turned the
thermostat on.
Right. Nothing. When we had those few hot days, it was unbearable.
Okay.
So I thought maybe it was the thermostat. It wasn't working. So I called OSI. I can't deal with them. I mean, I don't...
I hear you.
Okay.
Did they come out?
No, but I have an oil contract.
Okay.
And so the guy came and he was fixing, you know, tuning up the oil burner, whatever it is.
Okay.
And I said to him, you know, I don't understand what's going on with the air conditioner. So he said, let me just see. So he turned it on, you know, the thermostat.
Yes.
And he put his hand by the vent and he said, it's not working because it should be
blowing
out hot air.
It's not blowing out anything.
It's not blowing anything, he said. You probably need Freon. I said, okay. So I called OSI and I can't deal with this one person in the office, and I deal with everybody.
I hear you.
Anyway,
me too, usually.
And
there's always that one exception.
I mean, I'll just tell you something very quickly. I've been using them since I'm here, which is like 19 years.
Okay.
I get coupons every year, and it goes on my credit card, and the end of the year, I pay.
Yep.
This year, I was paying $205 a month. She sent me coupon, and my last month was $80, which means they charged me more than I used.
Yes.
I get coupons, so next year, it's $354.
A month.
A month.
That's for oil delivered, or?
Yeah.
All right. Oil's expensive now.
So I called her. Yeah, but don't tell me that OSI doesn't have a contract at last year's prices.
I hear you. They do.
So
maybe.
I called her and I said, look, I'm a senior citizen. I'm on Social Security.
Fixed budget.
It's $149 a month you're raising me. I said, charge me what you're charging me this year. And at the end of the year, we'll worry about it. I figured I may be dead. Who gives a crap? You know what I mean? She says, we can't do that. I underestimated you. It should be more. I said, where are you getting these figures from?
All right.
And she like wasn't even nice. So I said to her, you talk to your grandmother with that
attitude,
tone of voice?
Yeah.
Anyway. So that's my story.
So nothing's blowing.
Nothing's blowing. I called my son-in-law, John, who's from the other side of the tracks, and I said, tell me. And she said, you know Jenny? I said, of course I know Jenny. I see her all the time at their house. He said, call her. I called her.
And now I'm here.
Okay. Here's my situation. I've been.
We're gonna start with the thermostat. I'm putting a mask on, and we'll go from there.
I'm not scared of the corona, but I am making a wedding on Thursday, and I don't want to.
Here it is. Right there.
Okay. So let's do fan to on. Oh, it blows. Okay, it is blowing. The filter here. Filter's clean.
He changed the filter for me.
Okay. So before I turn this to, where's the outdoor unit?
Right out here.
Right there? Okay. Yeah, so hopefully I'll try to beat the rain. I'm going to put the cool on. So the fan blows, blowing. All right. I have a click. And let's go see. Cool is flashing. All right. Let me go see what's going on outside. Hopefully the rain will be somewhat forgiving. Or maybe not.
Yeah, it's pouring rain again. All right. I got my Subco umbrella. And let's see. Blowing air, and let's see, my electrical compartment is on the other side. Squeeze it right here. Let's see what kind of unit we got here.
What do we got there? It's gonna be an R22, is it gonna be? R22.
I don't know. Let me be somewhat adventurous here. Okay. I don't know. I don't know if we got a compressor. I do know we got an effing storm. Look at this. And I am literally on top of the clogged gutters. Oy. All right. I think I'm gonna start my R22 gauges, but I'm gonna get the yellow jacket, the analog ones, only because I don't want to get my testos wet. This is crazy. Under normal circumstances, I would have said, "Listen, we gotta wait for the rain to stop." But I'm feeling a little adventurous right now. I need to feed the people. I need to satisfy this senior. And give her a cooling in it hot in her hot house. All right. My yellow hose doesn't have the Schrader core depressor. And as you can see, she's empty. There's no refrigerant in the system. Looks like the line set goes up to the attic. Looks like she's empty. And that means we got a leak. Now I do know that the suction side service port cap was on super tight. I had to go get a little baby channel locks, but yeah, she's empty. All right, I got a valve depressor on my suction, and I got my high side and my liquid side, and still no pressure. She's empty. Let's go give her the news. I brought the rain. That's the reason why I'm late, because every time it rains, there's not much I can do, especially when I'm working with high voltage.
Yeah.
let me give you the news.
Yeah.
It's not good, but I laughed when the previous technician said, oh, it probably needs Freon, where it's a common misconception. You know, everyone always wants to say, oh, it needs more Freon, when normally, like 9 times out of 10, it's an electrical problem. Thermostat, wiring, you know, an electrical part that's no longer working. But unfortunately, in your case, there's no refrigerant in the system. Which means you have a leak, or leaks, plural. And there's no easy way to make this go away.
What would cause a leak?
Normal wear and tear.
But it's a new system.
Not that new. It's an R22 system. It's a Freon system.
I got it after Sandy.
Well, so good thing you mentioned that, because after Sandy, and a few years after the phase out period was started in 2010, you can get R22 for Freon outdoor units that didn't come with any Freon in it. So if you had a Freon system, you need a new outdoor unit, we could still buy one and then you add the Freon. The Freon was still being manufactured, they still made the units, you know, they found like a loophole in the law and they still, manufacturers still sold us equipment. The age of the system is as old as the oldest component. So if the component in the attic is 20 years old, it's a 20-year-old system. Even though it has a new engine, or a fairly new engine, or a 10-year-old engine, it's still a 20-year-old system. So there's no easy way of going about this. Freon is not manufactured anymore. It's ridiculously expensive. Like the filter system, let's say you said, Mike, fill it up, we'll deal with it. You're gonna spend thousands of dollars today just to refill it. Seriously, thousands of dollars. So if it wasn't, the weather was better, well, let's talk about what we can do. Number one, do nothing. You don't have air conditioning. Number two, we add, and I don't suggest this, I'm just giving you options. Number two, we add what you need, have a nice day. When it leaks out, however long that is, that's how much time you have left. It could be a day, week, month, year, whenever. Number three, we add the refrigerant, we add a sealant or a dye to the system to try to help us locate the leak on a future service call. Number four, we do a leak search. We find the leak and we pinpoint what is actually is leaking, make the repair or replace the component or the system at that point. Or number five, replace the entire system. The unit is in the attic?
I guess so.
Is there like a pull down stairs?
Yep.
So let's take a look at that and I'll give you my opinion once I see that, what you should do. But right now, I'm not gonna take your money and just add Freon because I don't know how long it's gonna last. And literally, you can give me $2,000 and it could last a week or a day. We don't know. I'll put the mask back on, we'll go look at the attic, and we'll take it from there.
All right. Let's see. We have a light. Oh, we have a Rood. Oh, that's no good. Is there a light switch? No light switch. All right, chances are it's in the evaporator, but let's just see what we got. This is one of those uni boys. Let's see, 24? No, it's a, what is that? Model number. Filter dryer is. The line set looks like it wraps around that way. So ideally, if it's in the evaporator, all right, it is what it is.
All right, given the overall condition, which is good, not bad, I would suggest, and again, this is just professional opinion, do one of two things. Number one, because of just the refrigerant that it uses, replace the system. Or alternatively, we do a leak search. Now, let me tell you what a leak search is. We pressurize the system with nitrogen at high pressure, and we monitor the system, right? And then we have electronic methods, or soapy water, for example, and we try to pinpoint what's leaking. If the outdoor coil is leaking, we may be able to fix it or alternatively replace the whole entire outdoor unit. If the coil, and these coils are like similar to car radiators.
Mm-hmm.
If the coil inside the air handler, which is the blower in the attic, if that is leaking, we can probably replace the evaporator coil. Again, but all these options are time consuming and I'm not going to sugarcoat anything, are expensive. You know, labor is expensive. Nitrogen, not so much, but it's a lot more than it was last year. And the components will be expensive. If I need to replace the evaporator coil, you're spending thousands and thousands of dollars. Because you also have the cost of the refrigerant that we have to add back in, the Freon. We're still going to add that back in. It's not going to magically, you know, come with the system.
Right.
So unless the leak is in the outdoor unit.
If the leak's in the outdoor unit, we can put in an outdoor unit that's compatible with Freon. It's still not the newer refrigerant, but it's cheaper than Freon. You're not gonna spend over $200 a pound and you need like 10 pounds of it. You know, you'll spend half that, but it's still a cost. So I would recommend, as a professional, replace the system. Alternatively, if you don't wanna spend the money on that, we can come back probably tomorrow, weather will be better. In the morning, we pressurize the system and then we wait an hour or two and we find where the leak is and then we tell you how to fix it.
Okay, so now let me try to figure out.
Can we go back outside?
Yeah.
Because it's easier to breathe. Yeah. Okay. Easier to talk outside.
Yeah.
So like I said, no pressure. Those are the things to consider.
Okay.
If the system's really not in bad shape, it's not terrible. If it was in worse of a shape or in bad shape, I would say, let's not bother wasting your money. But there's always a possibility that we find the leak, we make a repair, and then another leak develops.
Right.
But it also holds true for a new system, but at least in a new system, it's guaranteed and you have a warranty. Here, there's no warranty or guarantee on the equipment because it's aged.
Right.
So it is what it is.
Yeah. I mean, I just need to think about it.
Yeah, of course.
Because the truth of the matter is, I mean, I think it may be time for me to get rid of that. Get rid of the house. I mean,
Something to consider. So like I said, today is just pouring on and off. It's really not, it's summer, but it's 70. So it's really not bad, but
I know
if you can maintain, you know, for a while and to decide what you want to do.
I mean,
again, I don't mind regardless. Whatever you want to do, we'll do. If you don't do anything, that's fine too. But I want you to make the best decision, what's right for you. So if you're thinking about moving, do it.
Yeah,
you know, there's nothing for sale. It'll sell in a day. So, but then you'll have to contend with, you know, seller concession for the...
I go into an apartment.
There you go.
I don't want, you know.
So, that's that. Any questions?
No.
Okay. Think about it. Let me know what you want to do.
Okay.
And we'll go from there.
All right. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome, ma'am. Have a great day. All right, guys. Finished up that service call. And I keep it real. 24/7. Actually 24/6, so I don't work 24/7. And again, no pressure. This is no high pressure sales here. If I really wanted to, I know how to seal the deal, but I am not going to pressurize my clients. I don't do that. I give them the options. I give them, you know, professional advice on what I would do, and we go from there. If they want to look for a leak, we'll look for a leak. They want to replace it, we'll replace it. Plain and simple. What would you do? Let's get your thoughts and feedback down in the comment section down below. What would you do as an HVAC professional? Pressure them or give them the options, let them make a decision or something else. Catch you in the next one, guys. Be well. God bless. Stay safe.